Thanks so much for joining us for this midweek meditation. I'm Pat Smith of Knox Presbyterian Church in Naperville, Illinois. We're taking a quick look at a passage we'll give a fuller treatment to coming up this weekend, live streaming at 9 and 10:30. And we would also, that's Central Time here in the U.S., and we also will have it available on our YouTube channel to be watched anytime. So we invite you back for a fuller treatment of this passage. We're going to pick up one aspect of it for today, 1 John chapter 3, starting at verse 11. Let me read for us. This is the message you have heard from the beginning. We should love one another. We must not be like Cain, who belonged to the evil one and killed his brother. And why did he kill him? Because Cain had been doing what was evil, and his brother had been doing what was righteous. So don't be surprised, dear brothers and sisters, if the world hates you. If we love our brothers and sisters who are believers, it proves that we have passed from death to life. But a person who has no love is still dead. Anyone who hates another brother or sister is really a murderer at heart, and you know that murderers don't have eternal life within them. We know what real love is because Jesus gave up his life for us. So we also ought to give up our lives for our brothers and sisters. If someone has enough money to live well and sees a brother or sister in need but shows no compassion, how can God's love be in that person? Dear children, let's not merely say that we love each other. Let's show the truth by our actions. Our actions will show that we belong to the truth, so we will be confident when we stand before God. Even if we feel guilty, God is greater than our feelings, and he knows everything. Dear friends, if we don't feel guilty, we can come to God with bold confidence, and we will receive from him whatever we ask, because we obey him and do the things that please him. And this is his commandment. We must believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he commanded us. Those who obey God's commandments remain in fellowship with him and he with them. And we know he lives in us because the Spirit he gives us lives in us. Every time we read from this book, God intends for us to gain understanding by the Spirit, understanding of mind and heart and life. And I pray that's true for each one of us. This passage has many, many themes worked out through it. The connecting piece is the one that I want to draw us to today. And that connecting piece is this theme of love. Love lived out in care for one another. That as fellow Christians committed to life in Christ, built together as a community, as we spoke about last week, we also want to give evidence then with everything that we are to truly love one another without excuse, without exception. No excuse, no exception, nothing should stand in the way of our loving each other. And that love shows up in how we care for one another. So wherever love is shaky with someone else, that our care gets a little shaky, we're no longer thinking of them first and wanting to do our best for them, we need to come back to this text to remember we are called to love at all times, to care at all times, and to live that out fully every way we possibly can, with God's help and God's strength to lead us all through it. Today, it's all about care because we are to live out the theme of love. Let's pray. God, thank you for helping us to recognize that love is always the commandment by which we are to live. Now, that love comes in ways that really challenges us sometimes. It's not always easy to love others. It's not always easy to stand for what's best for everyone and not look just to our own interest, but truly love selflessly, just as you loved us. But we want to do that. We hear our calling to do that. Today then, in the days to come, help us to live out this love, no matter what, without excuse, without exception. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.